the last class that not everybody has those resistance bands or the resistance loops that I was using or ankle weights. So it seems that a lot of people do have some weights looking around at home. So I've decided to do today's class using just these weights, but I will let you know when you can add ankle weights or resistance bands as well if you do have them. Just this might be a little bit more inclusive for everybody. And then just another quick little note, as you can hear, I do have my music playing in the background again. I have made you guys another playlist, a new playlist for this class. So I put the link below to my Spotify. The class is called Full Body Class on my Spotify, so I made the playlist specifically for this, so feel free to listen along as we work out. So let's just get started right away. We're going to start with my favorite warm-up on an all fours position, getting that core warm. So we're going to have our arms straight, our wrists underneath our shoulders, knees underneath the hips. I just want you to start off by finding that Pilates breathing. So we inhale through the nose, and then exhale through pursed lips. Nice strong exhale, tightening through the core. Good. Just start to find that breathing for a few here. Just starting to turn on that core, front to back, side to side. Don't lock into your elbows. I want a soft bend into the elbows. Good. From here, we're going to take a nice deep inhale. Try to keep your spine nice and steady as you reach the left arm forward, right leg up. Inhale. Exhale, bring that down. Let's go to the other side. Right arm forward, left leg up. And bring it down. Keep going side to side. We inhale as we reach. Bring it down. Good. Reach. Bring it down. Keep going here side to side. You guys may notice that I really do like using this one as a warm-up. It's a great way to warm up the legs, glutes, and hamstrings. Shoulders are getting warm by stabilizing. And of course, our core is working to move, to stabilize against that movement. Good. Just a few more on each side. Reach. Bring it down. Make sure you're squeezing through those glutes and hamstrings as you lift the leg. Trying to keep your low back nice and steady. Good. Just one more on each side. Last one on the other side. Good. From here, we're going to stay on our hands and knees. Don't worry, you'll get off your wrists soon. We're going to go into one of my favorite exercises. It's called bear, well, at least that's what I call it. So I still want us in this all fours position, but we're going to tuck our toes this time. I want you to think of rounding through the shoulder blades as opposed to retracting. So try to think pushing your shoulder blades away from one another, pulling the belly up, and just hovering the knees off of the mat. Just hovering, not too high, literally just hovering above the mat, and just hold. This is a modified plank position, so you should be thinking of a plank here. Keep rounding through those shoulder blades, not through the spine, just through the shoulder blades. From here, I want you to tap your right knee to the center of the mat, lift. Left knee to the center of the mat, lift. Very slow, controlled movements, tapping one knee to the center of the mat and back. To the center of the mat, little oblique twist, tap, tap. You'll let your pelvis move with you slightly as you tap that knee. Let's do four more on each side. Keep that breathing going. Last two on each side. Last one. And just hold, hold. For 10, hovering those knees still. Keep pulling that belly away from the floor. 3, 2, last one. And you can come down for just a moment. Stretch through those arms. So you should have felt like that was a modified plank. We are going to go into a full plank, just a quick one, just to make sure we're nice and warm before we go into our ab work here. So I want us down on our forearms, getting you off of those wrists, shoulders directly over your elbows. If you're doing a modified plank, your knees are nice and far back so that you can get a straight line. If you're coming into a full plank, tuck your toes, legs together, and hold. Nice long straight line. Keep your kneecaps and your hips pointing down. Try not to downward dog or worm out, okay? Keep a nice long line. Keep your gaze just in front of the hands. We hold. Keep breathing. For 10. 5, 4, 3, 2, last one. Okay. So we should be a little bit warm. We're gonna come onto our backs now. Lying down flat onto our backs. Okay, let's get into some more isolated ab work. So, first things first, I just want everybody to remember or be reminded about what our imprint is. So, I want you to find that nice little space under your low back. So, with your feet flat on the mat, you should feel that tiny little space, like you can fit a little blueberry under your low back. So this is our nice neutral spine, so allowing that natural curve of the low back. And we're just gonna do a few imprints. So when we imprint, we use our abdominals in the front of the stomach here to pull our ribs to our hips, and it helps us flatten that blueberry. So squish that blueberry under the low back. So your low back should be touching the mat. Inhale, come back to neutral. Exhale, make sure it's happening through the front of the tummy here, flattening that low back. Inhale, back to neutral. Good. Again, just a slight rock. You're pulling your pelvis towards you. Inhale, back. Good. And back. Just a few more. Good. Make sure you really find that abdominal contraction to create this movement through the pelvis. Good. So let's squish that blueberry, guys, and hold it. So I should not be able to slide my fingers underneath your low back. Your low back is snug against the mat here, right? Okay, good. Now keep your low back snug on the mat. Lifting your legs up to a nice 90 degree position here. Try to avoid letting your knees come in. Try to keep your thighs away so you have this nice straight line. If you are feeling low back pain though, bring your knees in just a little bit to ease off on that low back. Good. From here, we're gonna keep our hands down by our side. We're just gonna start with some toe taps. Good, so let's start right leg and then left. Making sure we're keeping that bend behind the knee as the leg goes away. This is just a quick warm up. We're not gonna stay here for long. Good. Making sure that low back is nice and snug. You're using those abdominals to pull your tailbone, pull your pelvis towards you, tucking to the tailbone. Good. Yes, just think of tightening through the front of the stomach as that leg moves away. Last one. All right, from here, going straight into it as promised. So, I need you to again, find that imprint. If you lost it, you cannot put your fingers under your low back here. Your hands are gonna come behind the head. All we're gonna do is keep the legs steady. We crunch up towards the thighs and down. Up towards the thighs and down. So allowing your hands to help hold the weight of your head, tucking your chin to your chest before you come up. Good. Nice, guys. Just five more. Last three. Last two. Last one. I want you to come on up and hold tiny little pulses at the top. So you're staying up and just pulsing. For five, four, three. Last one, and you can come down. Ooh, just take a quick little breather. We're gonna do that again, but I'm gonna give you an option to make it even spicier. So for those of us that do have weights, whether it's dumbbell weights or even just ankle weights, whatever kind of weight you have, even if you're using books here, guys, heavy books, even canned goods, like a can of cream corn or something. Okay, so getting that weight, putting it along your shins, and then we're gonna put those legs right back up to that position. So we're doing the same thing, but this time we're gonna work those lower abdominals a lot more by keeping these 5 pound weights up nice and high, okay? So hands come behind the head, we curl up and down. Good, making sure you're using that exhale as you come up. So what tends to happen here is as we crunch up, the feet wanna go down because of the weight. You have to keep that nice 90 degree position to keep those lower abdominals working. Keeping that low back nice and close to the mat. Tucking your chin to your chest before you come up. Let's just do five more. Last three. Two. Last one. And up and pulse. Tiny pulses. For five. Three, two, last one, and you can come down. Okay, you can take your weights off of your shins. Again, if you didn't have the weights on your shins, you can still do it without, still just as hard. Good job, guys. Okay, so from here, we're just gonna go into an oblique isolated exercise. So what I'm gonna do for this one is I'm going to leave the balancing aspect out of it a little bit more so we can just really focus on the obliques. So to begin, we'll start by lifting the left leg up to a tabletop position. Our right foot is staying down. If you do want more challenge, guys, I'll give you an option. Otherwise, right now, we're just gonna keep that right foot down. Left leg stays in tabletop. Hands come behind the head again. We're gonna tuck our chin in our chest and come up and over towards that left knee and down. When you come up, guys, I want that whole right side of your shoulder and your back to come up off the mat. So tucking your chin in your chest, up and over to that left side. Inhale, come all the way down. Tucking your chin in your chest, up and over and down. So your left elbow should be almost touching the ground because you're twisting so much. Good, keeping your elbows wide. Up and over and down. Up and over. Good, so you should feel an intense isolation through those left obliques. Okay, I really want you to think of shortening and twisting through those left obliques here. We're gonna stay up in two. If you want that extra bit of challenge, guys, straighten that right leg to a nice long diagonal. Good, otherwise leave it down. On your next one, come up and over, and we just pulse at the top. Reach further, further. So you're staying up, and you're just pulsing at the top. For five, four, three, last one, and you can come down. Okay, we gotta do the other side. Again, the whole point of this exercise is to get more stability so that we can really commit to the twist. So when you're coming up and over, I really want you to think of feeling that through that right side, okay? So left foot staying down, right leg up to tabletop. Again, if you want more challenge, you can hover that left foot up to a nice long diagonal or even to a tabletop. I'm gonna leave it down just so we can show the isolated version of this. So hands coming behind the head. Again, keeping your legs still. It's just the upper body moving. So we tuck our chin to our chest. We come up and over and down. Up and over. Exhale as you come up, inhale as you come down. Good. You should feel that work in that right side. Good. Let your hands help carry your head. Up and over. Make sure you're getting that height and then that twist. Keeping that left opposite hip heavy on the floor. It's all about slow and controlled movements for this one. Don't rush through it too fast. I want you to take the time to really find those obliques on the right side. Okay, we stay up on the next one for our pulses, guys. So come on up and over, and then we pulse just at the top. Just the upper body pulsing. Leg is staying still. For five, four, last two, last one. Whew, you can come down and take a little break. All right, guys, you can grab behind your thighs and roll up, or just come up to a seated position however you would like. Okay, good job. We are gonna do one more little ab set before we move on to an upper body portion of the workout. So I want you to find your sit bones here. So find your bony bits in your bum and just come to a nice seated position. I want our legs straight for this one. Don't worry if your hips are tight and you can't sit straight. We are going to be rolling back anyhow. So to begin, I just want your arms nice and far forward, palms facing in, legs are nice and straight. We're gonna roll down into a nice half roll back position. Again, making sure we curl through that spine. I don't want you extending here. So we're pulling our belly in to find that nice flexion through the low back, shoulders down out of the ears, making a nice C-shape with our upper body here. Toes are pointed, legs are on. We're gonna just hold this position. We're gonna lift the right leg straight up in between the arms. Inhale, bring it down. Again, the right leg. We're not switching sides, we're staying on the right side. So leg lifts straight up and down. Exhale up, inhale down. Keep pulling your belly in, keep pulling your shoulders out of your ears. For three, two, bring it down. Come forward, just a quick little break, because your obliques should be freaking out from the last exercise and this one. Okay, we're gonna roll back down. Find that nice C-curve. Left leg goes this time, left leg up and down. Nice and straight with the toes pointed here, guys. Upper body staying still as that leg lifts up. It's all in that left side of abdominals, pulling that leg up. Good. For four. Last two. Last one. And if you come forward, take a quick little break. Whew. Okay, guys, we're gonna go back into that position. We're gonna add a little twist here. Again, theme today is a little bit of oblique, so legs are gonna be nice and straight again, quads are on. I want you to roll down into that position. Again, pulling into that low belly. Arms are straight. Okay, from here, we're gonna lift the right leg up, twist to the outside of the leg, pull it in, bring it down. Left leg up, twist, forward, down. Right leg up, twist to the outside of the right leg, inhale, forward, down. Left leg up, twist, forward, down. Making sure that when you're lifting your leg, guys, your legs are straight, okay? That's really important. Again, right leg up, twist, forward. Bring it down. Left leg up, twist, forward. Just one more on each side. Down. Come forward. Take a quick little break. We're gonna finish off with alternating leg lifts, okay? Whew, so make sure you're still using your breath, guys. Don't hold your breath doing abdominal work. Okay, it's really important to keep using that exhale. Your exhale is your friend. All right, let's roll back down. Let's finish this off. Arms are straight forward. Now we alternate. Right leg up and down. Left leg up and down. Keep pulling that belly in. Shoulders down. Nice, slow and controlled. Side to side, legs, each leg lifting up and down. Three more on each side, right, left, two more. One more. Whew, and you can come forward. All right, guys. So let's leave our abs alone for a little bit here. We are gonna move into an upper body portion of the workout. So we're going to do one of my favorite types of push-ups. It's called the lay-down push-up. So my favorite part about push-ups is the lowering down part, okay? We get a lot of great work getting nice and low. For that reason, I'm going to suggest doing these, at least for the first few, from the knees, just because I do really want to focus on getting low and really focusing on the upper body, the chest, shoulders, and pecs, as opposed to like a full body workout for this one. But by all means, if you're feeling real strong in your push-up area these days, please feel free to do a full push-up for this one. I'm going to demonstrate from my knees. So when we're on our knees, we need a nice long line to the body. I don't want your hips back, and I don't want you in a worm arch position. So I want us in a nice long straight line with our shoulders over top of our wrists. Okay, so keeping this long straight line, all we're gonna do is keep our hands nice and wide, elbows go back and out to the side as we lower all the way down, all the way to the floor. You tap your arms forward in front of you, pull them back just outside of your chest, exhale, push up. Again, lower down nice and slow, all the way down so that you can reach your arms forward, tap the floor in front of you, bring your hands back, pull the belly in, and lift up. Good, let's go again. Lowering down, really nice and slow. Tapping the chest, arms in front, arms back. When you guys lift up, make sure you're not worming yourself as you come up. You're trying to lift yourself up as one unit. Good, lower down. Tap in front, arms back, pull the belly in, and then lift. Good. It's all about the lower down here, guys, okay? The up is a nice explosive movement. But as we lower down, it's nice and slow and nasty, okay? Tap, lift up, nice one, fast movement on the way up. Slow on the way down, tap, fast on the way up. Slow on the way down, tap in front, from the toes. Okay? Just four more here, guys. Lower down. Tap in front. Pull them back nice and fast. Three more. Stay with me. Lower down. Two more. Last one. And I'm going to add a little bit of spice here, guys. We're going to push all the way up. Hold the push-up position. Come halfway down only, and we pulse down an inch, up an inch, just at that halfway. For eight. Five, four, three, two, last one. And you can push back. Send your bum back. Whew, should be feeling that quite a lot. Okay, so from here, we're gonna go into our tricep dip. So for this, I'm gonna use my couch. You can use your couch, an ottoman, a stool, or a chair. Anything about this height that you can do tricep dips on. If you don't have anything, you can also do it on the floor, and I'll show you how to do that. Otherwise, we're just gonna bring our hands just outside of our hip distance. I want all 10 fingers facing forward. And then you're gonna make sure your elbows are facing straight back. You're gonna have your feet out in front of you with your knees bent. The further out your feet are, the harder it is. So you can keep your knees bent and your feet down. Elbows are gonna be straight back. Trying to keep a straight back, all we're gonna do is lower our bums down to the floor and lift. Down to the floor and lift. Good. Down and up. Lower, lift. Lower, lift. Good. Keep going here. Lower and lift. You guys know I love pulsing, so you know we're gonna pulse it out in four. Three more, full range. Down and up. Last two. Last one. Good, and then from here, you're gonna lower down just about halfway and pulse it out. Down, up, little down and up pulses. Elbow straight back, strong shoulders, core in for six, five, four, three, two, last one. And you can bring it forward. So we are gonna do one more set of those lay down push-ups. Just to finish them off, we're not gonna do as many reps. And then we're gonna finish off that pulsing and then we'll go into the lower body portion of the workout, okay? So once again, finding your hands directly underneath your shoulders. You're gonna be starting to feel pretty fatigued to the arms here. So just stay with me, we go into lower body right away. So nice long straight line through the body. And we're gonna again, lower ourselves down, tap in front. Push up nice and fast. Just nine more, tap. And lift, slowly lower down, tap, push up. Good. Try to make sure you're lifting the whole body up at once on your way up. Good, for four. That pulsing is coming up, guys, so let's get ready. Last two. You ready? Last one. Tap. Bring the hands under. Coming all the way up. From here, come halfway down and pulse it out. Pull that belly in for eight. Should be feeling that burn, guys. Five, four, three, two. Last one. Ooh. So here you can just do a nice little wrist stretch. You can reverse your wrist so all of your fingers are facing towards you. Just stretch those wrists out a little bit here. Good. All right, guys, good job. So let's get our lower body warm. So from here, we're just gonna go straight onto our backs. If you do have resistance bands, guys, feel free to put the resistance band around your thighs for this one. So if you do have a resistance loop, you can put it around both legs and have the loop just above the knee joint. So you guys know, if you know me, you'll know that hip rolls are my all-time favorite exercise, and it's almost impossible to do a class with me where we don't do them. They're so good for our glutes and hamstrings, and they open up our hips, and we're nice and supported by the floor. So I need your feet sit bone distance apart, so in line with your hips, knees separated. Your feet are not too far away from you. Okay, again, I always kind of use, like you should almost be able to touch your heels. So just making sure that when we come up, we have that nice long straight line through the front of the shin. I don't want your feet too close to you, but I definitely don't want them too far away either. I want to get a good amount of glutes. So if you have the resistance band, you can just keep your legs parallel. Good. From here, your hands are going to be down for the first few. We're going to work through our spine one vertebrae at a time. So let's pull that belly in, squeeze the glutes, roll your hips up one vertebrae at a time, coming just to that spot in between the shoulder blades. I don't want you coming up too high into a yoga back bend. I want you to just find this nice high bridge position, resting between the shoulder blades. Holding at the top for an inhale, and then exhale, we roll down one vertebrae at a time. Oh, I love this song. Okay, so when you're ready again, scoop the belly, squeeze the bum, roll up, try to touch every part of the back as you roll up. Hold at the top for an inhale. Slowly roll down for your exhale. Good. Let's just do a couple more. I really want you to think of your spine as a string of pearls. You're rolling up one pearl at a time, holding at the top. As you roll down, one vertebrae at a time, especially through the low back. Should be feeling those glutes turning on. Roll up one more time. Okay, guys, I want you to stay at the top for this one. So staying up nice and high, pulling your ribs down. They want to pop up, so make sure you're constantly keeping your abdominals on to keep those ribs nice and close towards the hips. So from here, we're just going to slowly lower down almost halfway. Just almost. Your bum is just hovering over the floor, and then we lift up. If you want a little bit more challenge, you can reach your arms up towards the ceiling. Good. The weight is into the heels of the feet here, guys. Hinging as we lower down and lift. We're just simply hinging and opening. When you come down, think of it as an off, and then when you come up, on. Off glutes, on glutes. Using your hamstrings to help pull you up. Lower, lift. Down, up. Try and squeeze a little deeper at the top, guys. Really get into it. Inhale down, squeeze at the top. Should be feeling those glutes nice and warm here. That hamstring connection right underneath the bum should be connecting with those glutes. Let's do four more. Make sure you're really twisting at the top, sending your pubic bone to the ceiling. Last two. Last one, hold at the top. Slowly roll down, one vertebrae at a time. Take a quick break, don't move unless you need to readjust. We're going right back up. All right, if you have a resistance band here, you can push out into the band to go into external rotation. Otherwise, we're just going to stay parallel, up to you. If you want that extra with the side bump, go ahead. But we are going to be working side bump quite a bit in the next couple exercises, so be mindful of that. All right, guys, so again, legs nice and parallel. This time, we're just going to roll up and stay right away. So again, glutes twisting and pushing the hips up, hamstrings nice and connected, ribs down. From here, we're going to go into smaller pulses. Down an inch, up. Down, up. Tiny pulses. Lower, lift. Exhale. Lower, lift. Lower, lift. Tiny pulses. Good. Squeeze and twist at the top. Squeeze. Twist. Make sure those glutes are controlling that movement up. Ribs are staying down. Good. Keep going here. Again, if you want more challenge, arms up towards the ceiling. For five, four, three, ribs down, neck relaxed. Last one, come to the top, hold. From here, we're going to quickly lower down. Tap the bum, right back up. Tap the bum, right back up. Tap, lift. Ooh, guys, you should be feeling those glutes and those hamstrings ready to work. Good. For eight, seven, thrust. Hips down, nice line at the top. For four, Last three. Last two. Last one. Come up nice and high. And then slowly rolling down. Okay, just hug your knees in towards your chest for a quick moment. Rolling back and forth. All right. Let's keep going. So we are going into a single leg flow here. So that was both legs working at once. Now it's time to just isolate one leg. You guys know how I love to do that. So for this next one, this is an opportunity for us to use our weights. So I just have a little 5-pound dumbbell here. What we're gonna do with this weight is we're gonna come into an all fours position again. We're gonna take the weight behind our knee. So you're gonna straighten your right leg back, taking the weight, putting it behind your knee, and then you're gonna squeeze the weight behind the knee. You can also put a towel around the weight behind the knee if it is hurting to keep the weight behind the knee. So feel free to grab a little tea towel or something to put around the weight just to cushion the weight behind the knee. If you don't have weights, this is a good time to put either ankle weights on your right ankle, or you can put a resistance band around your thighs, and we can do this with the resistance band as well. So you have some options. Also, nothing is an option too. No weights at all. It's a great option, still hard. So wrists underneath the shoulders, soft bend in the elbows, knees under the hips, nice long straight spine, keeping that low back steady. All we're gonna do is squeeze that right heel towards the bum, flexing at the foot. We're gonna lift the leg up and lower down. That's it for now. Just staying nice and parallel. Lift and lower. Keep your knee traveling through that center line. Good. Lift and lower. If you are not using a weight behind the knee, I still want you to imagine that you had to hold on to a weight behind the knee just to keep those hamstrings working and keep pulling that heel towards the back of your head. And if you're using a resistance band instead, you should just be pressing against that resistance band to lift and lower. If you do want more challenge here, guys, you can lift the left arm forward so you're balancing only on that right arm and left leg. Otherwise, just keep nice and strong through those shoulders. If your wrists are bothering you, you can come onto your forearms. Good. Keep going here. I'm gonna come back onto my hands. Last two. On your next one, guys, I want you to lift the leg up, hold, pulse, pulse. Tiny pulse is right at the top. For 8, 7, 6, 5, pull the belly in for 3, 2, last one. Come down, stay here. Don't move that weight unless you need to adjust it or if it's super uncomfortable, you can leave it, get rid of it. Otherwise, we're gonna keep that weight behind our knee. We're gonna go into circles. So again, if you're not using the weight, I want you to keep that nice tight bend behind the knee. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna straighten the leg up, over to the side, forward, and then up. Out to the side, forward, and up. Nice big circles with that right leg. Holding on to that weight. Again, if you don't have a weight, make sure you keep that knee bent. Working all four corners of the bum on that right side. So think you have four corners on that right side. Make sure you tap every corner as you circle around. Good. Last two. Last one. And you guys know we always reverse circles. So right leg, forward, up and over. Same leg working, guys, I know. Up and over. You're gonna feel your left leg working to just stabilize in this position. Forward, up and around. Good. Try not to lock out into that right elbow. Pulling up in that belly, keeping that low back nice and strong. Nice big circles. Good. For four, last three, last two, last one. Come down, we're finishing off how we started, okay, and then we're done on this right side with this one. So hold, left, right leg up, down, just 9 more. I know, we're still working that right leg, you're getting tired, just stay with me here. 6. Nice and high with that heel. Low back nice and steady. Last three. Last two. Last one. and you can come down. Oh, you probably feel both legs burning right now. My left leg is burning, just stabilizing as that right leg was moving. Okay, from here. So this is another great option. If you have a weight, I'm gonna show you how we use weights for this one. I have done it with a resistance band as well as with nothing. So if you have a resistance band, guys, this one is really great with the resistance band around the shins or around the thighs. I like it around the shins. If you don't have a resistance band, if you do have weights, that's why I'm doing this, just to show that you can use lots of things for this exercise. So a weight, again, heavy book, heavy, anything heavy that you can put on top of your leg. So this one, we kind of just have to balance the weight. So I'm just gonna put the weight here. Just be mindful you're not holding the weight with the arm. You're just simply putting the weight on top of the leg. I'm just gonna use my first three fingers here just to keep it stable and to make sure my arm isn't doing the work. We're in a side plank position, so we have a nice long line through the body. My left elbow is underneath my left shoulder, and I'm leaving this bottom waistline nice and active. Legs are straight, again, just balancing that weight on top and letting the leg do the work as we lift up and down. Making sure your hips stay nice and stacked. Good. My hips stacked, I'm just gonna show you. I mean, your hips are not rolling back, okay? I want your hips directly on top of one another. Good, and your kneecap is staying forward as we lift and lower. So this just adds a little bit of extra weight for that side bum to work to lift up. It's still a great exercise with nothing and just doing this. Good. Otherwise, keep lifting up against that weight or the resistance band, whatever you're working with. Trying to give you guys some options here. Good. Four, three. Keep letting, making sure that top hip is not rolling back. On your next one, lifting up and hold. You're gonna keep that weight on top as you circle around, back and forward. Nice big circles. That leg is staying straight, and you're just simply balancing that weight on top of the leg. If you have a resistance band, you're constantly pushing into the band as much as you can. For three, you know we're gonna reverse those circles. Last one, and reverse. Forward, up, and back. Forward, up, and back. Oh God, that right leg should be really feeling it. We've been working it for a while now. For four, three, two, last one, and come down, take a quick little break. Just 10 lifts on that right leg before we move on. Nice long straight legs, here we go, let's finish it off. 10, 9, 8, 4, 3, 2, last one, and you can come down. You can take that weight or resistance band off. Okay, since we're already in this position, let's put a side plank in before we keep going. Why not, right? So we're gonna make sure again, that left elbow is directly under the shoulder, definitely not too close towards you, okay? I need a nice long straight line through that left arm. Long straight legs, if you need to leave the bottom knee down, that's a great option for our side plank, or you can separate your feet for a little bit more stability. Otherwise, when you're ready, up into our side plank, arm up, let's hold. Nice long straight line, creating as much space underneath you as you can. For 10, hold. 5, 4, 3, 2, last one, and you can come down. Just a quick little side plank. Okay guys, we're gonna do one more thing on the right leg, just one more thing, and then we'll move on. So you guys know I love finishing off with our single leg hip bridge lifts. So lying onto our backs, we already warmed up with our hip rolls. So now we're gonna go into our single leg on that right leg. Again, if you have a resistance band, you can put it around your thighs. I'm gonna do this one with nothing, but this time, so you're gonna leave your right foot down. Again, make sure your right heel is close enough where you can almost touch it. Your left leg is gonna be straight this time,
Okay, so nice high straight leg. Arms are down by your side. We're gonna push the weight into our right heel as we lift our hips up and down. Keeping your ribs nice and tight. Oh, you're gonna feel those hamstrings working right away. Lift up and down. Trying to keep your left leg straight up towards the ceiling. Lifting nice and high. Good. Oh, I know that right side. Ooh, I can feel my hamstrings. Let's just do four more and then we're gonna pulse it out. Last two. Take breaks when you need to. Last one. Come up nice and high. Hold nice and high. Down halfway up. Down halfway up. Down halfway up for five, four, three, two. Last one. And you can come down. Ooh. Give that right leg. Ooh, a little break. If you are feeling like your right hamstring was just freaking out, almost crampy, you're doing it right. It's very normal to feel our hamstring freak out a little bit when we isolate it like that, so don't be concerned if that was really intense for your right leg hamstrings. That is very common and inevitable. Okay, so we're gonna start that little flow over again on the left leg instead this time. So we're gonna grab our weight. Again, I know I sound like a broken record. It's still a great exercise without the weight. You can use a resistance band, ankle weights. Just make sure whatever you are doing, we're on the left leg. So I'm putting the weight behind my left knee and then I'm squeezing it to hold it. Again, using a towel around the weight is a great option just to take a little bit of that discomfort away. So I need you, hands underneath the shoulders, knees underneath the hips, nice strong lower back with our core here. Good. When you're ready, we're just going to travel through the central line with that left knee as we lift straight up and down. So we're not going out to the side at all. We're lowering and lifting. Lower, lift. Lower, lift. Good. Keeping your spine nice and straight, including your neck. So your gaze should be down towards the floor. Good. Try not to lock up through those elbows. Nice soft bend. Good, guys. Making sure your glutes are lifting that leg high. Hamstring is working to hold on to that weight. Okay, so it's hamstrings and glutes here. You're gonna feel that right side pretty soon. It's hard to stabilize in this position, so don't be alarmed when you feel that right side working too. Good. Four more, then we pulse it out. Last two. On your next one, lift, hold, pulse, pulse, pulse. Good. Keep holding for four, three, two, one, and come down. Don't change position. You know we're going into circles. Okay, so keep that weight behind the knee if you've got it there. And again, if you don't, especially for this one, making sure you're keeping that heel towards the bum. I don't want your legs straightening out. So when you're ready, and even if you're not, let's just do it. So we're gonna start by sending our leg up, over to the side, and forward. Back and up, out to the side, and forward. So you're going up to fire hydrant position, forward. Up, fire hydrant, forward. Nice big circles. Good, leaning your weight into that left side, but we're not locking up to that left elbow. Good. Good, guys, keep going. Making sure you're hitting all four corners on that left side. So think of ticking off each corner of your glutes on the left side. Last one this direction. And reverse, so whatever way you were just circling. So forward, up, up, and down. Forward, out to the side, up, and forward. And down. Nice big circles, same size circles as we were just doing the other way. I know fatigue, but don't let these circles be smaller than the first set. Nice and big. Good, guys. All right, four more. Remember how we finished? Last two. And last one. Come up and down. Good. You're just going to hold this position, keeping that weight behind the left knee. Good. And when you're ready, squeezing in, you're going to lift up and down. Up and down. Lift up and down. Heel high and down. Good. Five more, then you're done. Five. Four. Last three. Two. Last one. And you can bring it down. Ooh, take that weight. All right, from here, we're gonna lie down onto our right elbow. So, again, you guys know what your options are here. So the option to use no weight, yes weight, ankle weight, or resistance bands. So we're gonna make sure first that our right elbow is under our right shoulder. Okay, from here, making sure you keep that bottom waistline active, hips nice and stacked. Taking that weight, again, making sure your arm is not holding the weight. We're just simply keeping it on top by balancing with our fingers, making sure it's just the leg lifting the weight. Good, from here, nice and active through the upper body as we lift up and down, keeping hips stacked. I want your kneecap pointing straight forward, so that left leg is nice and parallel. Good. Again, if you're pushing into a resistance band, just going as high as you can without coming into external rotation. Making sure that you don't start to roll back to that top hip. Good, and don't dump into your right shoulder here. Nice and active in this modified side plank position. Good. Lift, lower, lift, lower. Nice long straight leg. Good. You know we're going into circles. I know you're gonna feel that side bump tomorrow, guys. Last two. Last one. Bring it down, just take a quick moment. Reset to that right shoulder if you need to. When you're ready, lifting up and hip line with the hip, we circle back, up and forward. Back, up and forward. Like I said, you can really use anything as weight, right? Nice heavy book, big textbooks, even a can of something, a bag of something. Good, nice big circles, keeping that leg straight. Take breaks when you need to. I'm taking a little break. Good. Last two. And guys, reverse. We gotta do it. Reverse. Other way. Other way. Whatever way you work, just going, okay? So me, I'm going forward, up, and back now. Just as big of circles, please. Don't make these smaller because you're tired. Just as big. For five. Four, three, two, last one. Take a little break, but don't move, because we still have to finish off with those nasty 10 lifts. I know I'm so mean. Okay, let's just get it over with. So legs nice and long and strong, hips stacked. Holding that weight, this is it for this left side line. Lift for 10, 9, 8, 7, ooh, five. Yes, you can. For four. Come on, keep going. Three. Two. Last one. Great. Okay. Oh, side plank. Oh, I almost forgot. Okay, so we're staying on that right elbow. Again, guys, if you have anything going on in your shoulders, please leave your bottom knee down. Otherwise, it's so much for that shoulder to handle. Again, separating the feet for more support or having our feet stacked for the full version. All right, when you're ready, let's push on up into a nice high side plank. creating as much space underneath you as possible, and just hold. Get your hips nice and high. Hold. Your hand can be on your hips. Just hold. Keep breathing. Nice, strong right shoulder. Hold for 10. 4, 3, 2, last one. All right, let's come onto our backs. All right, so going into that single leg lift on the right side. Okay, again, guys, just form, little form check here, making sure you can almost touch your left heel, sorry, my left heel, not my right. So you can keep your left foot down. Right leg is coming up nice and high. Okay, again, we're gonna keep a nice long straight line through the body. Right leg is up nice and straight towards the ceiling. Again, if you have a resistance band, you can use that. Ankle weight, you can use that on the right leg. Otherwise, when you're ready, pushing the weight into the left heel to lift ourselves up and down. Lift all the way up and come down. You'll probably feel the hamstrings on the left side right away. I know I am. Lift, lower. You still have to squeeze to the right side just to make sure that your hips are staying nice and level so the right hip isn't sinking down. Lift up and down. All the way up. Keeping your right leg straight up towards the ceiling. Lifting nice and high. Keeping your ribs down. Okay, guys, we stay up in 3. Going into those pulses. 2. On your next one, let's do this. Come all the way up, hold. Down halfway up, down halfway up. Push through. Come on, guys, almost done. Push through. For 5. 4, 3, 2. Last one. Oh, that left leg. Just take a quick little moment. Oh, don't dive into a hamstring stretch, okay? Just give it a second before you do that. Sometimes if we go straight into a deep hamstring stretch, it can really strain to that side. Okay, from here, let's roll on up. All right, guys, we're gonna finish off with a plank, and then you guys are all done. So let's, again, we're gonna come to a forearm plank. We are gonna add a little bit of spice here. If you're not interested in the spice, please feel free to just hold the plank or coming on down onto your knees for a modified plank. All right, so last exercise. So I really want you to empty your tanks for me here, guys. Don't leave any gas left in the tank. Give me it all. All right, so again, onto our forearms. If you need to do a plank from the knees, making sure you're nice and long through the spine, you're not like this or this. Just a little reminder. Otherwise, when you're ready, I want your feet separated, nice and wide to the width of our hips. Nice and separate through the feet, holding nice long line. From here, guys, we're just gonna tap our right knee down, hip staying still, and lift. Tap the left knee down, up. Notice how my body's staying still as I tap and lift. Tap and lift, tap and lift. One more on each side, then we tap with both knees. Tap, lift, a lot of lower abdominal work to stabilize through the hips as you do this. For 5, 4, 3, last 2, last 1, and then just hold the plank for 10, 9, keep holding, quads are on, breathe for 5, 4, 3, 2, last one. And then let's just take a nice shell stretch here. So knees nice and wide, arms in front, pulling your belly up away from the thighs, and just hold. Good. Now let's slowly roll ourselves up. Perfect timing for my cool down song. Oh, all right, guys, we are done. I hope that was as hard for you as it was for me. Again, just don't worry about it if you don't have the equipment. difficult without the equipment. And then again, feel free to repeat certain exercises. If you like certain things and you want to try them again, just throw them in right now. But thank you guys so much for joining me. I love that you guys are enjoying the classes. I'm going to keep them coming. I said this in my last class. If you have any requests, like if you want a standing class, if you want an arms focus class, anything that you want, let me know in the comments below. And I love that stuff. Like, I love the challenge of coming up with things that you guys want. Just like last time, my playlist is underneath. I'm going to link it below. I made a playlist specifically for you guys. So playlist is right there. Feel free to listen along. And thank you guys so much. You can subscribe to my channel to stay in tune with the classes I'm posting. I'm going to keep them coming as much as I can. So thank you so much.